Now listening to the sounds of a god in the flesh. My lineage is ancient. I come from beyond any place you could imagine. In your imagination, mommy was my spaceship. It took her 9 months to get me here. I finally made it. Goodness gracious, great balls of fire. My star got 6 points, so I burn brighter than any pentagram on Hollywood sidewalk. I'm much too hot. You cannot cool me off. Now the sun don't chill, I love. Check the rhyme that I spill on y'all. It's the best by far. Initiate of the sacred brotherhood of elite rappers. I'm a master builder, grand verbalizer, young old timer, the tippy top shot original Don Dada. It's written in the stars. Look me up then, two or three bars. Got you pay attention. I'm gifted, my rap is mystic. It's cold that I speak, so the police missed it. Spray painted on the walls, the writing's on the walls. I'm gifted, my rap is mystic. It's cold that I speak, so the police missed it. Put on some real tough shit that I could rock to. To write the illest words you ever could bop to. I live the illest life you ever could have. So much joy I cry, so much pain I laugh. At my best I am excellence, at my worst I'm not inspired by the beat. Shit come out weak, it's not bad for a bad day. I smack you and knock your head off, damn. I don't know my own strength like a lion. I was just trying to play, it's not my fault. You fall apart so easy, I need to be with my own kind. Take me to where the rap music is powerful, beats and rhymes. Whole nother channel, don't be so shallow. Expand your taste, it's more to life than your narrow mind think. And we live from the refuge. Is anybody out there? It's written in the stars. Look me up then, two or three bars. Got you pay attention. I'm gifted, my rap is mystic. It's cold that I speak, so the police missed it. Spray painted on the walls, the writing's on the walls. I'm gifted, my rap is mystic. It's codes that I speak, so the police missed it.
Keep them pretty scared, because unless they're properly scared and frightened that all sorts of devils are going to destroy them from outside or inside or somewhere, they may start to think.
Islam. Peace and love, Moors. We're here again for Canaanland Moors class, 27th of June. And while this plays, I'll get the email open.
They didn't want to fall out, but don't nobody want to build nothing. And edify, I don't know how the MSDMA has you utterly confused. I don't know who was your teacher. Brother, can you please put in the chat who taught you about the teachings of the Prophet Obadu Ali? Who taught you about the Prophet Obadu Ali? See, that's the first problem. If you say you have studied the teachings of the Prophet Obadu Ali and you're confused, you maybe you haven't studied the teachings of the Prophet Obadu Ali. Let me tell you something. Let me do a checklist real quick. A right to travel is not more signs. UCC is not more signs. Making IDs and all of these more identification cards is not more signs. Going to all these lectures to hear about UCCs and your indigenous capacity of rights of indigenous people is not more signs. It's not. It's some feel-good talk. treaty that was only about commerce with Morocco and the United States. I didn't have a chance to touch on that. But the treaty that only was about commerce, with trade and commerce with Morocco and the United States, the Peace and Friendship Treaty, has nothing to do with Moore signs. Nothing. And you will never know about Moore signs if you do not involve yourself with somebody who is presently functioning in the full capacity as a Moorish American Muslim. You will never know it. You will never know it. You see somebody with a fez, first thing you want to ask them, who's your grand sheikh? Second thing you want to ask, if they say, well, I don't go to a temple, ask them, have you ever been to a temple? If they say no, red flag. Put this out, red flag. We're going to wait the battle. They call this a battle. We're going to wait the battle. I'm telling you.
No. At that point, you have to come to the conclusion that these people are for the democracy. Have to. You have to come to the conclusion now that they're with the other side. Because I like to bring up Nova Jawali's literature. So Nova Jawali, the 101 questionnaire. Nobujwali in the 101 questionnaire told you that your flag's a red flag. Right. Specifically told you that your flag's a red flag. He told you your flag's a red flag. He's making reference to a red flag, but waves the banner. No, comically. When that's not even the form of government. He's waving a corporate banner as a red flag when his prophet, who he's talking about, gave him a red flag, right? But he didn't wave that. I remember if they have the two flag stand. If they have the two flag stand, remember, they have the two flag stand, right? He has the choice between the banner and the national flag of the Moorish Americans. He has a choice, and he didn't pick this up and say red flag. Like, why? Because he doesn't have authority to talk under this flag. That's why they always have the banner first. So we're red flagging your fake red flag. Because it is folly at its heights. It is folly at its heights for these people to have something to say. It didn't work with Corin Gaines. Now they're bringing in the Louisiana shooter guy now. Then he came on the record and said, don't even tie me to any groups. And then they're still going to use him? You tell me they're not working for the same yellow journalist democracy? Who Nobujwali warned these Moors about the avalanche of lies that these people are going to tell on their platforms? Do you recognize that that's Nobujwali's prophecy manifested? That he warned the Moors about the avalanche of lies, and then Moors are looking around at European news people and whatever like that, and they're not even realizing the avalanche of lies right over them with a fez and a turban. This is about birthrights for the 55 billionth time. This is about birthrights. Strictly, this is about birthrights. Nobujwali was a universal prophet. So if anybody's heard about Moors and they choose not to study Noble Drew Ali, that's on them. They will get judgment for not adhering to his teachings, though, because he really was a prophet. So you could play around all you want with the birthright. But, you know, if you're saying that you're more and you study trust law and you study this law and that law, estate law and all that stuff, and you studied all these things, but your life sucks, your life really sucks, and things are happening in your life that makes you have to actually stop and say, why is this happening to me? Oh, more, like I study, read my Quran and all that stuff, and I do that, and I read the 101 questionnaire, and I study the Moorish literature, and I say the Moorish American prayer every day. Life still sucks. Something's definitely wrong with self. And half these people have problems with self and don't want to deal with self. You want to do everything else except self. Refuse to deal with self. Because then if you deal with self, now there's no boogeyman. There's no dirty Moors to blame. Right? You realize that the dirty moral was self. Just because. Frequency doesn't lie. Had about 4 people this week. Right? That came to me on the back door. Yeah, you know, yeah, I used to study under so-and-so who you guys talk BS about, and yeah, you're right. They're really just doing church. They're not building anything either. They're just talking that they're building stuff. The folly's up. Everything is falling on the individual now. You can't put it somewhere. If you claim that you had this knowledge for however long it was, and you knew what the 5 principles are, and you knew who Noble Drew Ali was, and you took the position of, you know, I'll study this stuff for a little bit, you know, because, you know, it's judgment time right now, and guaranteed, because trust me, people call me, the sincere people call me with their BS. And when we actually sit down and discuss for no fee, you know what I mean? There's no consultation with them or nothing like that. You know what I mean? There's just Moors out there who have enough courage to say, I'm going to leave a message or I'm going to send an email or whatever like that. And, you know, they might have a situation. We might just talk about it just because we're Moors. Like, well, you know what I mean? Better than talk about basketball or something. Let's talk about something in your life. Try to help you out. Right? You know, just building a conversation. And when we backtrack the situation, they come to the realization that it was them that got them in this whole long 4-year mess that they got themselves into because they want to jump headfirst in the shallow end of birthrights off the 50-foot diving board. Right? Caught up in the illusion of what this is. Because again, Islam to the Moors that study, right, that don't have time for, like, if they're on some social media thing, it's drop their post or whatever and they're out. Go live with something, and they're out. Right? In and out. Why? Because there's way more important things to do. Just like, you know what I mean? There's way more important thing for me to do for 2 weeks than sit on here and do classes for F-boys to come leave stupid comments and stuff like that. Like, you know what I mean? Any new people, they send an email. Patiently waiting to get their email answered. You know what I mean? I'm chilling. You know, taking some time. Because, you know, one thing that we're taught as Moors, because it's not club or nothing like that, you know what I mean? Don't think that you're obligated to, you know, save everybody.
Like, that is not what this is about. This is not about, you know what I mean, even though we can get charged from the sun and all that stuff, that, you know, oh yeah, you know, we're straight. You know what I mean? Just bring all your stuff, we'll deal with it. No, it's no, sorry. It's not working like that either. Because again, this is birthrights. You know what I mean? And birthright requires that individuals take time to themselves, especially if they're in leadership or whatever. You know what I mean? Especially if they have influence. Now you take some time to yourself. However you do that, that's on you, whatever. Take some time to yourself. Everybody does it. These guys get their jet and stuff like that, go places, you know what I mean? Nobody says nothing to them. At their private island, nobody's concerned. All right, so don't be concerned. Recognize that if it's birthrights, you're on your own. So you better get to studying to know what it is as far as your birthright, because guarantee you, ain't no Moorish group, ain't no temple, ain't no great seal, ain't no nothing that's going to give you your birthright. You're going to study to know what your birthright is, and then you will be what you know. If you don't know, don't be. Real simple. If you're not 100% sure how to put those four wires together without getting electrocuted to death, then leave the wires alone to somebody who's qualified. It's nothing on you if you didn't do it. It's okay, you know what I mean? Humble yourself, you know what I mean? Now, because you didn't show the nationality card and get on the plane and then, you know what I mean, means that it doesn't work or whatever, right? It's birthrights. This is not how stuff works or doesn't work, or when should I do this and how should I do this. You don't question blinking and breathing. From your birth, something that you did. That's what this is supposed to be. This is supposed to be that secure. Like, blinking, stop and actually, you know, for people who are new, right? Really stop and think about blinking and breathing. And whether you got permission or whatever to do that. And then after you think about that, relate that to your birthrights and the exercising of your birthrights, no matter what it is. If it's in your mind, if a particular action or activity comes into your mind, when I say birthrights, that thing you should be doing, like blinking and breathing. If it's not manifesting like that, then you do not know. Therefore, you cannot be. Because Moors, forget black guys and whoever else, Moorish Americans, Moorish American Muslims, Moor Americans, Americans, Aboriginal, Indigenous people, they be what they know. Period. If they don't know, the hope is that they seek to find so they could know, so they could be. And the more they know, the more they're going to be. Right? So, just wanted to put it out there that this is birthrights. This is not a club. This is nationhood. This is not some membership into some knock three times and then you could come in. Right? I'm telling you as a representative of Moorish Science Temple of America that Moorish Science Temple of America is not the all and be all of the Moorish movement. It's not. Know thyself is the all and be all of the Moorish movement. Know thyself. That's what it's all about. It's about nothing else other than you better know yourself. Before you start saying you're Moor and you're Moorish American and you got rights and you got this and that, you better know who you are. That's why, again, we give honors to studious Moors who, you know what I mean, study. That's like there ain't nothing else to do but study. Honors to the Moors who choose to do that. Who that? No matter when I call them, they're studying. Doesn't matter. You know what I mean? And they have lives and children and all that type of stuff. They gotta take their children to school and to graduation and all that. And they still have time to make sure they put in their studying. Because it's a birthright. It's not a club. It is a birthright. Few questions, so I'll try to flow through all these. You know, some of these go back to beginning of June. Brother Yassin. This is my question from the other day. I'm following it up with some Quranic verses that I found. Don't take it as disrespect. Just take it as you helping me get some insight. Islam, Brother Kudro, in the name of Allah, the most gracious, most merciful. I know we spoke just the other evening, but it's many verses that are in the Holy Quran which speak of God Allah having no son, that the heavens and the mountains are about to destroy them who speak this. I don't know if you have ever read the Gospel of Barnabas. Jesus says he isn't the Son of God, chapter 92-94, and that was Satan's handiwork. It also speaks of the creation of man in chapter 1, 2, 3, for which I see all Moors believe, but I've never heard where they got that information from. Just whenever you're not busy, shoot me back with your reasoning. Now, we've said before that when it comes to Moor science and the teachings of Noble Drew Ali, when we're making reference to Jesus, it means justice, because that's what's told, that's what's taught, that's the instructions in the literature, right? Holy Quran of the Moor Science Temple of America, right? Now, any mention of Satan, devil, or anything like that. Alright? Give five names that are given to the descendants of Adam and Eve. Lucifer, Satan, devil, dragon, and beast. What is the devil sometimes called? Lower self. So that means the beast is the lower self. The dragon is the lower self. Satan is the lower self. And Eve and Lucifer is the lower self. Right? The lower self is not just the devil because it said devil. All the names given to the descendants of Adam and Eve are the lower self. So anytime you see them, you're relating them to lower self. Alright? What did the higher self say to the lower self at one time when he met him? Where are you going, Satan? I know that's in the lessons, the crossroads. Right? That's in Buddhist teachings. That's not just secluded to Moors only. That's not just in Islam only or in Christianity only. Because the mystics know that it's one God. It's one religion on the planet. There's not all these different everybody worshiping stuff. It's not different stuff. It's all the same stuff once you look at it with an esoteric eye. Which Noble Zhu Ali was a metaphysician. So he's not speaking for dumb Negroes, even though he was speaking for dumb Negroes. He was speaking from a higher plane for those who were on the mind frame to recognize where he was coming from, even though he's speaking on this lower vibration. Even though he's saying, you're not Negro, black, colored, studious, higher thinking Moors know that means impropria persona. As soon as he said that, you are not Negro, black, colored, automatically, when Moors started studying, they realized that, oh, I'm not Negro, black, colored because I'm impropria persona. Not because I'm African or because I'm Moorish or whatever. Because Noble Zhu Ali said you're not Negro, black, color, because those are statuses. Those can't be identities of people. Now again, Negro, black, color people are the ones that have the issue. Because again, brother Yassin, right, like we built, so you already know what's up, right? Like we talked about. You're coming from the perspective of you're a black guy and you're part of this religion that all these people belong to. They're coming from a perspective of I'm a national and this is my creed and, you know, we don't fight with anybody because everybody's stuff is the same. These people know that we're Moors. So when you go to mosque and all that type of stuff and, you know what I mean, they're engaging you on some brotherhood. If you don't have a nationality, that's strictly because the religion says that, you know, you're their brother. But outside of there, you know what I mean? You're paying tax and all that stuff just like anybody else who comes up in these stores or whatever. We're not playing Muslim stuff when it's commerce time with you Negroes. We know that because we hear Negroes argue and talk about that. How all these other people are coming in their community taking stuff. Yeah, they're nationals. And you're not. And they know this. No different than when we went to our solstice celebration. Right? Now, do your research on Fort Erie. Do your research on Fort Erie and the battle at Fort Erie between the French and the British. Right? So, we're there while they're doing this, you know what I mean, reenactment of the war or whatever. You know what I'm saying? So after we do our stuff and we're finished, we're chilling at the car. A car comes in the parking lot. So how the parking lot's set up is you go into the parking lot, you gotta go left, that's where all the parking at. To the right, there's some cars parked on the grass, but it's a walkway going to wherever it's going. So, dude pulls into the parking lot, pulls into the walkway. Right? Hey, what are you guys doing or whatever? You know what I mean? Or just chilling. What are you doing? He's like, no. What are you guys doing? You know, because he sees the feathers. So we're asking him, you know, what's your nationality? Oh, yeah, I'm from Iran. Da, da, da. You know, where are you guys from? Oh, we're from Morocco, you know, Maghreb. You know, this side. He's like, oh, yeah, Morocco, Maghreb. I know. You know, what's going on here? Oh yeah, they're doing the reenactment of the whatever. Oh, those bastards, right? This is Iranian guy, right? Oh, those bastards. Yeah, we know what they did. We know what they did to your people and all this type of stuff, man. You know, have a nice day, you know what I mean? Everybody in the car, you know, bye, and all that stuff, like the wave, like family, you know what I mean? Right? This guy knows. He wasn't questioning Quran verses and all that stuff. He's from Iran, pale. He seen us with feathers on, and immediately his approach was, hey, how you guys doing? What's going on? You know what I mean? Because that's the history of our ancient foremothers and forefathers. Why we keep saying that this is not a club. This is not something that you can join because you went to somewhere and they gave you a card, now you're the thing. No, that is not what this is. This is actual factual that everybody knows that you are your ancient foremothers and forefathers coming in, but not if you dress like niggers. You know how many people that we're just out, no Fez Day, you might have your baseball hat on, you know what I mean? People even questioning this. Hey, how come that? I've never seen that before. What is that? You know? Or they see like the ring and the hat and they make a seven joke. It's always other people. It's not, never other Asiatics. Right? It's always the Europeans. Checking my compass. And then when we check our brothers and sisters' compass who claim that they know themselves, you know, we're the bad guys because we don't want to accept that, you know, we're African people. No, we're not African. We're not black. We're not none of that. We're impropria persona. That means you know who you are. If you don't know, shouldn't be talking. Which again, goes right back again to what Noble Jolly brought this for. For man to know thyself. If man's not knowing thyself while they have these Qurans and Circle Sevens and Torahs, and if they don't know themselves, those books are useless. They serve no purpose whatsoever. Because the lessons in the book are activated by the user. The key, the unlocking of the keys is man being the book. What I did, all men must do. Why? Because it's life. Like, everybody's going to have their own stuff they got to deal with. You worry about me on a cross and all that? You better worry about all these plagues coming. Don't worry about me on the cross and all that stuff. You guys got stuff coming that I'm glad I'm on this cross right here. Beam me up, Scotty. Let's go. Because I'm good with the cross. That's crazy. Think you want to be around now? Craziness going on? Right? So don't get caught up and twisted up in the dogmatization of religion. Right? We're Sufis. Right? We're Sufis. Simple as that. Simple and plain. What was that? Right. Right, simple and plain. Muhammad, the first Sufi of Islam. So, don't equate, when you hear more say Islam or something like that, don't equate us to just some Muhammad whatever. Right? That's not what we take this as. Active studious Moors. When they say we're Moorish American Muslim, we're not talking about we went to some temple and some temple sprinkled the stuff on us and make us Muslims. We're Moorish American Muslim because we're mystics. We got crystals and all that type of stuff. We study astrology and all that. We know. You know what I mean? Black box days, stay your ass home. Don't do too much stuff. Because it's part of the culture. Right? Even if you don't know it, somebody else, you can go to them and get them to do it. Because, you know, it's part of the culture. And everybody's on a different level and everybody's in a different place. But once the five principles are being adhered to, then there should be no issues. The only time there's issues is when five principles are not, you know what I mean? People have them out of order. So we're showing you. Farzana Moon, the first Sufi of Islam. So if he's the first Sufi, then anybody who claims that they're Muslim and Muhammad is their prophet, they should be Sufis. They shouldn't be Sunni, Shiite, and whatever else that they're claiming that they are. They shouldn't be that. Like, they shouldn't be that. If they're that, then you know, whatever. Take it however you want to take it. You know what I mean? But I'm not gonna disgrace the Prophet Muhammad and push that. You know what I mean? He was on some dogmatize Islam, like what people are doing today and calling that religion. Right? He was a mystic. Turban up, like, what do you mean? Of course he was a mystic. Right? No, before hijab, turban. Right? Got his birthright. This is not the club. This is a birthright. The more people understand that this is a birthright, the less people who are treating this like a club would exist. Right? Somebody running up to you asking you who your grand sheikh is or whatever like that to qualify if you're a Moor, like, that's outrageous. That's outrageous. You know what I mean? That's for later in the conversation, who their grand sheikh is or whatever. If you see a Moor, the first initial interaction should be Islam, like, hey, a Moor. You know what I mean? Islam, you know what I mean? You know, Bill, you know, what are you doing here? Yo, I'm just here for, you know, whatever. Oh, yeah, just, you know what I mean? You want to go get something to eat, man? Right, let's go. I was just about to go do that, man. And then in conversation, that might come up. But no, if you're a Moor, and a Moor is coming to you, and they can't have a conversation with you until they know who your grand sheikh is and all that, the Moor is dirty Moors. Just immediately stop talking with that Moor and go another direction. Because it matters not who your grand sheikh is, or who your supreme grand sheikh is. It matters not. Because we have a covenant that predates those positions. There's a covenant that talks about brothers and sisters, not titles in there. So tell these guys hell out of here with their titles. Because the covenant doesn't have titles in there. The Moorish covenant doesn't do titles. They're talking about brothers and sisters in that. And again, come back to like what we were saying in the beginning. If you're not being somebody's brother and sister, don't expect to have brothers and sisters. Don't expect to recognize that we're Moors and just birthrights, but then forget that there's a covenant that goes with that. That's imperative. Because the covenant's a contract, which is a treaty. But they, you know, they're going to say they don't recognize treaties and stuff like that because, you know, treaties are a fraud and they're only for commerce and have nothing to do with Moors or have nothing to do with Moorish American Muslims. All right. Keep thinking that. Well, he told the Moors everything I say is spirit. And that Moors better heed. Moors haven't heeded. So they're getting what they get. Right, Quranic verse. People of the scripture, do not exaggerate in your religion nor utter aught concerning Allah. Save the truth. The Messiah, Jesus, son of Mary, was only a messenger of Allah, and his word which he conveyed unto Mary, and a spirit from him. So believe in Allah and his messengers, and say not three, cease. It is better for you. Allah is only one God, for far is it removed from his transcendent majesty that he would have a son. He is all that is in the heavens and that is in the earth, and Allah is sufficient as defender. So what's that saying? The so-called prophets that are sent by Allah are merely his messengers. Now, I know that you're coming from some perspective that we worship Noble Drew Ali, or we, you know what I mean, parade him around like some religious figure or something like that. I met him as that name. In studying, I found out about these Timothy Drew and whatever like that, but I met him as Prophet Noble Drew Ali. Now, I've had enough experience with his teachings to know that, okay, yeah, he's a prophet for real, because things that he said in the 1920s have manifested. And these aren't things that, you know, somebody's just gonna put out there doing a lecture. There's a reason prophets say certain things, right? So don't get caught up in this thing of how Muslims look at Muhammad, Moors look at Noble Drew Ali, how, you know, whoever looks at Moses, Moors look at Noble Drew Ali. Don't even equate it. Because Noble Drew Ali taught Moors that man is spirit, not the flesh. So we're not even looking at this man. Like, that's not even what it's about. It's about the lessons that he brought and how the lessons can transform man from his lower self to his higher self. We have no issues with teachings in the Quran, like Noble Drew Ali taught us. We honor all true and divine prophets. So if your prophet is true and divine, you don't need to check his teachings. We already know that the name's on the list. He got the pass. What's the teachings of your prophet? Well, the teaching of our prophet is, you know, love unto thy neighbor and love unto thy thing. Love the fish and love the air and love. What's the name of your prophet? 1, 2, 3 prophet. He said love everything? Yeah. Noble Drew Ali might have missed his name, but if your prophet's dealing with love, everything, we need to build. Because there's some information that we can share. And again, that's how it is with Moors. That are really being what they know. Like I said, it's a Muslim brother. Email in class. You know what I mean? Like, how is this not unity? How could Moorish science not solve the problem if it's a brother that's a Muslim? You know, he does whatever he does in his time, whatever like that. This is his quote-unquote religion. There's not no debating or arguing or whatever like that. Like, we had great convo on the phone. He's a Muslim. Right? But like, I know more science. He knows that religion. Because why? It became to him like his blinking and his smelling. It's not something that he was taught to do. Something that when you realize you could do it, hey, you just did it. He is a Muslim because he's being what he knows. He's not part-time like some of these people that you see out here that say that they're Muslim and, you know what I mean, they're drinking 40s and stuff. We're talking about an individual found out about Moors and stuff like that, studying. Found out that there's a Quran, you know, automatically, you know, because he's a Muslim, you know, just, these guys have a Quran too and all that stuff, and, you know, but getting down to the information from someone who knows what this is, not, you know, some emotional YouTuber that just wants to make videos and get likes and be somebody on screen, no, like, somebody who actually teaches people, who saves people's life. Just because, you know what I mean, this information could do that. So why not help save some people? You know, there's another brother out there. So, you know, we don't, the same way that you would look at Sufis, look at Moorish American Muslims that are active and studious. How you look at Sufis. Right? You're not gonna say, if somebody says, I'm Sufi, and they're pale Arab or whatever like that, there's no question. There's no asking them what's their interpretation of anything, because you already know what their lane is. And it's already acknowledged that the Sufism lane is a higher degree than the mundane run around the cube and kiss the black stone Ramadan Muslims. There's a big difference in the teachings. Big difference. And it's acknowledged and respected amongst the Blackstone kissers. That, oh, Sufis, oh yeah, oh, Sufism, okay, yeah. And they do their alaykum salam and they're out of there. Ain't nothing to discuss. Right? So don't take it as some guys on YouTube is the reference point of what Moors are. You know, proofs have come to you, proofs have come unto you from your Lord. So whoso seeth, it is for his own good, and whoso is blindeth is blinded to his own hurt, and I am not a keeper over you. I am not a keeper over you. You're gonna know and be what you know, because I'm not a keeper over you. I can't be a keeper over you, because this is your birthright. It's for you to use your common sense and have your moral compass in the right direction so that you don't play yourself. Because you're not playing anybody. You're only playing yourself when you ride the dirty Moor rails. You're only playing yourself. Trust me, you're not playing people. Because half the people that get played, you know what I mean, they're so coward that they get disgusted and they just leave altogether. You know what I mean? And then the other people that get played, they get so disgruntled that they start doing that to other people. Opposed to, you know, kicking the bully in the nuts. They're gonna go bother everybody else with their issues. Opposed to dealing with the issue that has them, you know what I mean, mad, stressed out, whatever, at that time. The proofs that have come to you are from your Lord. You know, say whatever, but in relation to lords, that's Moorish history. Right? Like, there weren't lords in Kemet and all that. They'll say, Lord, yeah, he had Lord of the Perfect Black. They never said Lord in Kemet. Please, stop the BS. Right? It's relative to us. You see good, recognize good, then that's for your own good. But let's just say you're blind. Let's say you can't see the proof. Let's say truth is not available to your fore or hindsight. You're blinded from truth. The reality is that it's not finding the truth that's blinding you. It's yourself that's stopping you from seeing the truth. You yourself are stopping you from accepting the reality of self. And when one refuses to accept the responsibility that self has on the earth plane to self and to other selves, self will try to destroy the higher self. Because, you know, can't serve two masters, mind or man. You're either running with the higher self or you're running with the ego, which would lead to, you know, lower stuff. So we are, you know, alchemists. You know what I mean? Like, we're not just some people with fezzes on or whatever, right? We honor the ancestors and we honor the higher forces. Right. You know, again, speaking about references with sons of God and all that stuff, and you know what I mean, like, the light is knowledge. The light is always knowledge. Once you deal with light, know that it's knowledge. So the Son of God is the knowledge of God. The Son is the light. Right? The light bearer, Lucifer, is the knowledge. That's only, you know, for somebody Muslim, we're looking at it from a Sufi mindset. We're looking at it from a mystic mindset. So you say, well, I want to study Buddhism. Okay, well, there's Buddhism, then there's mystic Buddhism. I study Hinduism. Okay, there's Hinduism, then there's mystic Hinduism. There's Islam, there's mystic Islam. So you have to choose or you're going to be confused. Right. Brother Santra L. I came into contact with this link. You should take a look. It's amazing. I also have literature in PDF format on other models and patents. I would be happy to provide them. So you can look up anti-gravity and open system free energy. Searle effect generator. Anti-gravity and open system free energy. Searle effect generator. And that's Brother Santra L just sending out some info from ours. Brother Vincent, my question is, Moors with European bloodlines like me, distinguish the difference. If the mother is European, then that's the bloodline. If the mother is Asiatic, then that's the bloodline. So you keep going back until you find out the last mother, as far back as you could go. If the last mother is Asiatic, that's the bloodline. If the last mother is European, that's the bloodline. Right? Now, don't get caught up in can't be a Moor and then a Moor, and because the color game is not where it's at. It's about mindset. Okay? It's about mindset. Right? There are Europeans who use this information successfully because of their mindset. Right? They don't get the fight like Moors get. Exercising this same information. Right? Because their mindset is that they are naturalizing into the Moroccan Empire out of whatever jurisdiction that they were in. Right? This is how the European mindset is supposed to be with regard to this information. That I know that I'm not a Moor, I'm European. But under this occupational force, it would be wise to connect yourself with the Aboriginal Indigenous government. Why would you attach yourself to foreigners whose land it's not? Because when the foreigners leave, then you leave. If you show allegiance to the empire, then you're under a bigger jurisdiction than the jurisdiction that's trying to claim jurisdiction. Right? So, you know what I mean? We know about the history of, you know, the European mothers that had children and then coerced them to take the fathers out so they can rule the throne and all the stuff and all, have the power and all that. We already know what's up, right? But I'm gonna ride with somebody with a European mom that's sticking to the principles of love, truth, peace, freedom, and justice, honoring noble Juali and giving Moors their just due, than a dirty Moor playing around with the birthright. Because we're brothers and he's pure Asiatic, and then I'm gonna go with him even though we might have issues. No. I've been there, done that. And those are the worst ones. The ones that look like you. Those are the worst ones. Those are the ones that will sell you out faster than anybody else would sell you out. We'll take a, before the next question, we'll take a prodigy break for the next question.
Bumpy Johnson. You still have the light in your eyes. Praise God.
The original. Evil bastard, cutthroat warmonger, backstabber, betray your own mother. Your double tongue, double talk, cause you two-faced it. You triple six with a hiss like Satan. No good snake, you only speak lies. Slime bucket, scum of the universe, your eyes reveal that you have no soul and expose your true colors. I see you from 3 million miles away. You use a sneaky motherfucker, but you can't fool me. You not my bro, you not my sis. The devil doesn't have a skin color or complexion. So, you not my brother, you not my sister. Yeah, your skin might be brown, but I know that you down with about 2 billion demons. Listen, stay the fuck away from me, or get killed for treason against the Most High. You might got these other people scared of you, but that shit don't fly. Over here, we laugh at you, but it's not a joke. Cause people need to know about the black devil. Yeah, the real outcast. Your time is up, it's not the end of the world. It's the age of Aquarius. You're a deceiver. You got the whole world confused in a daze, like some rats in a maze. You're a shapeshifter. I don't care if you the Pope, the President, or Prime Minister, King, Queen, Prince, or Princess. You just frontin' for the public and frontin' for the press. But behind closed doors, What really goes on is ritualistic, cannibalistic, sadistic, masochistic, some real sick shit. The most wicked there is that ever lived. Under the sun, the infamous daywalker. The movie Blade's just metaphorical. Yes, the greatest trick that the devil ever pulled is convincing the world the devil don't exist. People have no clue. They looking for a red man with a pitchfork, but that's just not true. Some say it's the white man, but yo, I'm here to let you know you ain't know about the black devil. Yeah, yo, peace, peace, God. Today's mathematics, God. Science, man. Knowledge equality of all people. Even though physically we not all equal. Erase the racism. The only thing I see when I look at a person is good or evil. But the black man is God. Yeah, that shit sound good, but that shit don't apply when you try and get a job. This is real world music, reality rap. We spent too many years on that fantasy crap. It's time we deal with the facts. And the fact is, you're not better than somebody cause the color of your skin. After 3 years in prison, and a white boy showed me more love than any of my so-called niggas. So you can go and boof your doctrine. The only thing that matters is you negative or positive, and you could go to hell even where I'm sure you'll be fine with the rest of your kind. People are so blind, so deaf, so dumb, which proves you won the battle but the war not done. You might got these other people fooled, but you can't fool we, cause we know that you a black devil.
Right? Even locked up, paid all the dues already, and white boy showed him more love than his brothers. So every Moor is not your brother, and every European is not your enemy. Remember that. Remember that. Don't forget that. Right, Brother Malcolm, Islam Moors. My nom de guerre is Samuel Ray. Now, make sure you do your research on Samuel, the Archangel. And you know, you can do that. Go to rvbaypublications.com. Do your astrological research about Samuel. Keep in mind, L, Moorish title of nobility. So Samuel is, you know, somebody in your family knew if they're going to name you that. They might not have knew directly, but indirectly, intuitively, in the DNA, it was known that you were going to be on this info. They named you it. So there's no excuse. You have no reason to deny that you're a Moor. And play that you're black or whatever like that. Because even dumb nigger parents or whatever named you Samuel. Right? Born in North America and both parents born natives of the islands. So you're American. Point blank. Period. They're Asiatics. Mom and dad going all the way down the lines. Asiatics. Alright, so you're Aboriginal indigenous to the land. Being a student of Moorish science, what advice or instructions can you offer myself as the steps to take to self-educate and become an active participant in the movement? Right now, the self-education is what makes you an active participant in the movement. That's why we stress the Moors to make sure that they study. Study, study. And when you study some more, you think you got this, sorry, go back, study yourself, right? Self-education, remember again, Moors are so advanced that they answer their own questions when asking questions. This is how advanced Moors are. When Moors with eyes wide open, you're answering the question. You're answering your question in the question that you're asking. If that's not wide open, then we might as well pack it up and forget this. Dirty Moore's win, right? Let's all go pray to Noble Drew Ali right now. And go sing some Noble Drew Ali hymns and go get licenses and stuff again, start paying taxes. What advice or instructions can you offer myself as steps I must take to self-educate and become an active participant in the movement? Right? Like we're saying in the beginning, and we're driving home themes with the hammer. We're not moving from them. You must be what you know. If you do not know, you cannot be. So you cannot participate. You cannot participate without knowing what you're participating in. You must know your position. You must know where you stand. And that knowing where you stand is based on your secure knowledge, not how much you got on the tests that you took or whatever like that. How much work in the trenches have you done for self? Not for anybody else, for your own evolution. Your own refining of yourself is going to be you going into the muck and mire and coming out unscathed and then polishing off and then you're shiny. It's not somebody going in and then passing you the shine. Right? Remember the rooftop? You got the juice. Nobody gave it to him. He got it. Oh yeah, so-and-so, that's how you got the juice now because that guy gave you the juice. No. Right? But some reference points. You want to get as many books as you can dealing with Moorish history. Right? Because that's sort of the more lacking information. Because as we know, majority of our leaders were compromised and couldn't teach what they really were supposed to teach. So a lot of, you know, a lot of the master teachers, the Dr. Benz, John Henry Clarks, Ivan Van Sertima's, you know, they're legacy of historian does not big up the history they knew of the Moors. It usually goes into all the other stuff, right? But now when you start getting into the historical reference points of the Moroccan Empire and the Moorish nation and things like that, you have outside people that wrote on it, right? From their perspective. And the perspective that others have of the Moors, you know, like outside North America, historically, is that it is, you know, a group of the most honorable people that walk the face of the earth, right? Few people outside of North America speak from the perspective of the Moors did something bad or whatever like that. Majority of people honor what the Moors did. Right? Of course, rvbaypublications.com as your nucleus or your hub of information. right? So from there, you'll go out and get information. If, you know, like, because people have this thing about, you know, they can't, you know, they have to learn from all these different whatever, you know what I mean? The beautiful thing about RV Bay Publications is that you can get all things there. So you don't have to necessarily move yourself from that venue, right? Because the venue of RV Bay Publications is specifically for Moors who want to learn on their own. That's what it's for. It's deliberately and purposefully set up for people who, you know, want to be on the internet for 5 hours and they just want to be entrenched in studying, right? Because again, you know, we say that Moore science is everything. So when you're studying, it's Moore science. It's not you're studying something and then this thing over here. And everything's Moore science as far as studious active Moors. Other Moors will tell you differently. They'll make videos about it and tell you what Moore science is, and this is not Moore science, this is not Moore science, this is not Moore science, right? But, you know, everybody knows the Moors brought the world everything. So what, like, you know, where are these people's minds at? Their minds clearly not on this being birthrights. Their minds is on this is some little corner pocket. You know, only 8 balls go in there. No other balls go in there, just 8 balls. You have this big board though. But they're just telling you about just this one pocket, right? And they're not telling you about the other pockets. Okay? So stick to rvbaypublications.com. If you have access to parents, grandparents, and all that stuff, talk to them about this connection to the islands. Because, you know, when we start talking connecting to the islands, we're talking about Aboriginal Indigenous culture. Like I'm saying, you know, when we went back home, that you're going outside picking what you want to eat. Got a coconut off the tree. Mangoes off the tree, fruits off the tree, vegetables out the ground. There's no other options. If you go to the supermarket, that's what you're getting. Like, because the guy in the supermarket went, he got the stuff, he put that up. So you're still getting it, even if you go to market, you're still getting off the ground. You're not getting, you know, you could get, you know, was on a truck and came here. You know what I mean? It took 2 weeks to get here, and 2 weeks, that's how it got ripe in darkness in some container. That's how it got ripe. You want to know how come it tastes like BS, right? Look into the islands, connections there, you know? Because guarantee your Jamaica and Antigua connections have Aboriginal Indigenous roots. You can also go to Canaanland Moors and watch the Cujo L lecture in Philly, right? We are Aboriginals, or we are American, or something like that, right? There's no, what should I study? Study everything. Everything's your stuff. I mean, everything is your stuff. Brother Dietrich, Shalom, what do you brothers mean by nationality, right? Good. Excellent question. Shalom to you too, brother, for being one of the real ones. For being one of the real ones and sending an email. You know what I mean? Honors to you. Right? Because we don't get too many Hebrews sending questions with regard to their nationality as Marsh American. Right? So honors to you for wanting to know. Now, what do we mean by nationality? We could mean many things, but we mean what the definition says it is, right? So when we go to the definition of nationality, that quality or character which arises from the fact of a person belonging to a nation or state. So the nation that we belong to is the Moorish nation. We have a flag, it's called the Moorish flag. Also interpreted as Moroccan. That is our nationality. Some of our religions are Hebrew. Some of our religions are occult. Some of our religions are Islam. Some of our religions are Islamism. Some of our religions are I Self Law and Master. Some of our religions are Rastafarian. Some of our religions are Buddhist, Hindu. But nationality, that they're Moorish. So, we're not telling people, don't be part of your school of thought that made you who you are. We're yelling from outside the stadium saying, hey, come outside the stadium and see what this stadium is part of. Yeah, we understand you guys had your stadium there for 80 years and all that stuff. We get it. Well, you guys haven't been out the stadium in a long time, and a lot has changed out here. And you might want to come take a look. Right? So that's what we mean by nationality. Being tied to a nation. We're not even going to go deep. We're going to stop right there. Because Juali told us that he's bringing us back to our nationality and our divine creed. So once again, shalom to you, bro. And any more questions, feel free to email them in. Right? CanaanlandGuide@gmail.com. CanaanlandGuide@gmail.com. Islam to Brother Blue T Bay, who's been putting his work in to studying, dealing with the whole baby mama drama BS, trying to keep people from their children, and you know what I mean, the usual madness. You know, the brothers been staying strong in the battle. Matter of fact, Brother Blue T was one of the brothers who we met when doing youth work, and we did an exchange, youth exchange, you know what I mean? So we both went to each other's territory or whatever like that. Good times, and we just stayed in contact. And how much ever years later, you know what I mean? You know, people here who I've known, you know, talked about this, they, oh, I don't know about that, and you know, whatever like that. He's backing down this baby mama broad with writs and standing on birthrights right now. That, you know, based on the way that it's going, right? From what he's told me, like, we haven't talked. I'm just putting this out there so when he sees it. The perspective is that they know who the authority is. They know that if they can get the woman, then they have it all, right? But that can only happen if the man is incompetent. If the man's competent, he would stand up for the fact that this incompetent individual shouldn't even have jurisdiction over children. Forget that they're, because they're the mom. They're a crackhead. They're a go on the corner every night. Leave the baby at home alone. Why should, because she's mother, have that obligation to take care of that child that she's not taking care of? And then giving me a hard time when I want to see her and she's leaving her at home and crazy stuff or whatever. Right? So, Moors are out here battling Islam to the Moors, you know what I mean? Islam to Brother Yusuf, who, he's been battling them over some vacation. Vacation. This is how they're, you know, squeezing the clamp on people. Right? But again, only if they're incompetent. When they're competent, these people are picking at straws. Because they have no jurisdictional authority to do, say, or whatever, anything to a Moorish American. But we're listening to these crazy Moors out here, calling themselves, you know, whoever, with the world crushing them as their logo. And you think that they got something to give you. The world's crushing them as their logo. Think about it. The world's crushing them as their logo, but they're going to teach you something. Think and save yourself, Moors. Of course, we always got to get the testimonials. Sister Najwa L. sent one in, so we'll just put this one out there. Once again, if any Moors, if you're going through, you know, stuff, and you happen to, you know, realize, let me just try this nationality or whatever, and you start exercising your birthright, and weird things starting happening, portals start opening for you and stuff like that, because you say you're a Moor, you realize that you're getting the position, and you're, you know, getting the loan, and all this stuff, send all your testimonials in, so we can inspire other Moors who are riding the fence, that nationality and birthrights really works. So if you have a sincere testimonial of how nationality and birthrights has changed your perspective positively, please send an email to canaanlandguide@gmail.com. canaanlandguide@gmail.com. Now, if your testimonials are negative, they won't be considered or put on the air. So make sure that you send positive, uplifting testimonials. You know, for people who are coming into their birthrights to recognize the truth about their nationality and birthrights from Moors who are being. Not just going on YouTube and talking from their little room only. You know. They film from the room, sometimes they film from the temple, sometimes they film from the street corner, sometimes they, you know what I mean? And watch out for Moors who are just walking around empty streets by themselves, filming stuff, talking, right? Because everybody wants to be the man right now, and that's only Noble Drew Ali, ain't nobody else to be the man, right? So Sister Najwa, Islam family. Here's a quick note, family, on what I see on the road in North America. In the past 3 weeks, I have met and spoken with a Hebrew Israelite, a Moor, and a Mason. That level of contact says to me the word is getting out. The last contact I had yesterday was with the Mason, which is why I am sharing this message with you. This Masonic brother did not break his oath, yet there were little Masonic gameplay that I had to get through to get him to understand I am awake and aware. That being said, I told him to get Abdullah's book, Moors and Masonry, because he is speaking to you Prince Hall Masons and Eastern Stars. He said he would get the book. I also told him that we are waking up and we need them to wake up and step up too. His retort to me was, they are helping you wake up now. I asked, who was he talking about, the modern European? He said, yes, they're helping you guys wake up because you have no choice. You have to wake up now. This is the message. It confirms what the prophet said about the European helping him and also sheds light on the injunction Abdullah spoke about in the 1919 on Taharka's Not Moorish World, but on the other Taharka's broadcast that posted this morning. Abdullah's referencing the injunction by the Arab order over the ancient African order Prince Hall Masons at Texas in 1919. In the broadcast, Abdullah said that the African order lost their case because they failed to stand on birthrights and chose rather to stand on their charter being granted under a corporate status. The corporate status is probably one of the many reasons why there is so much confusion in 2007. So basically, when I told this Masonic brother that vow trumps his oath, I was probably on point in more ways than I knew at the time. Let the family know we have to wake up and stop being afraid of the modern Europeans. Let the order know that if we are family, Asiatics and Moors, they too must realize that their birthright status trumps any oath that subjugates and relegates them to being the butt boys and girls of the European brothers. Know that months ago, I spoke with a European Freemason, and he told me that the Arab order are under instructions not to even acknowledge an African order Mason who gives them the right responses. So true to power, we just need to wake up. Islam, Sister Najwa L, love, truth, peace, freedom, and justice. Right? Abdullah's book, MoorsandMasonry.org or MoorsCivilLetter.net. Waking up out here, Brother Sakembe. So this is Brother Sakembe is in Colorado, and he's looking for witnesses for his paperwork. Because he was watching the classes and he's found out that, you know, if there's Moors in Colorado that can witness for the brother, he's looking for Moors in Colorado or near Colorado, surrounding areas included. So it's really about the process. His email is really about the process of getting your paperwork, your name correction paperwork, and your judicial proclamation paperwork. Keep in mind that the Great Seal Association of Moorish Affairs, the purpose of the Great Seal was to make sure that these things were being done, right? From the perspective of you have governmental officials, right? That would provide for you whatever it is that you needed as a Moorish national to exercise to be, you know, who you are. In the early years of Great Seal, you know, we've spoken with elders in the Great Seal, and it was completely acknowledged, right? The exercising of your constitutional rights as Moorish Americans was something that was not violated by modern Europeans. They acknowledged everything. They were given Moors buildings and everything else. Right? As usual, the infighting is what causes majority of our opportunities to fail, you know, because somebody always, you know, has ulterior motives that they don't say up front. You know what I mean? Later on you find out that these people, you know, had no intentions for good in the first place, right? So the idea is that you get Moors that are of like mind in the jurisdiction where you're at to be your witnesses, and then you send your paperwork in with your signature and your two witnesses, and then you get it sealed. Upon receiving your paperwork back, you make your photocopies and you put whoever needs to know on notice of your name correction and judicial proclamation of your nationality. And, you know, prior to that, it is instructed that you've been studying before you do that. So don't, you know, today find out about this, tomorrow go get paperwork. Like, this, that's not how this works, because when we're dealing with the whole concept of the paperwork, the idea of the paperwork is that it is a written example of your mindset. So that's why we tell people, you know, it's not necessarily about, you know, you out there writing writs, but the writing of writs is going to get your mindset corrected, especially if you're using the reference writs that are on rvbaypublications.com. They will give you a perspective of how you should articulate yourself when dealing with the occupational forces, right? You don't want to deal with the occupational forces from a mindset that is not allodial, that is not constitutional, that is not based in understanding status and estate jurisdiction. The paperwork is an example of, like, when they read your paperwork, that should give them an idea of how much you really know. If they read your paperwork and think you know nothing, then your claim's probably going to be, you know, looked at as, you know, gibberish and, you know, that's frivolous and stuff like that, right? Because they're trained to make sure that when individuals come up that know, individuals present things to them that prove that they know, that they shut it down immediately as frivolous, as, you know, anti-government or whatever. But they're specifically doing that because of the magnitude of, if they let this go, if they reply wrong, what could happen? Because they really don't know how much you know. But based on what they read, they know you know enough to, you know, maybe, you know, respond to them with another letter after that first letter or first writ, right? So the idea of correcting, you know, your status and getting paperwork and all that stuff starts in your mind. It ultimately starts as a mindset first, and it has to be stressed again that you could only be what you know. There is no room for being what you don't know. You are going to get injured. Do not ever be what you don't know. Do not ever, you know, just throw up a gang sign just because you're in a gang neighborhood and you want to see which gang it is. Don't throw it. Don't do that. Right? No. Know thyself. Right? Important. Know thyself. Jay Brood. Inspired by the Moors in America supporting themselves, I wanted to know if you were brushed up on your laws, seeing that you are from Canada as well, and how to represent myself as a human being. Well, being that you're in Canada, first thing, that Canada's a private corporation, CIK number 00002300098 on the Security and Exchange, United States Security and Exchange Commission website. Punch in that number 00002300098. You'll find out that Canada's a corporation. So hence why we say Canaanland, because, you know, by saying Canaanland, we're talking about our jurisdiction as Moorish Americans. The quote-unquote laws of Canada are all acts, ordinances, statutes, and are not withstanding. Article 11 of the Articles of Confederation, Canada acceded to everything in the Union, which includes the enforcement of the Constitution for the United States of North America. Right? United States of North America, which Canada is part. As the erosion of constitutional rights happened, so did the influx of, you know, man-made laws to administer to the Aboriginal indigenous people, which turned into the Black Codes, Negro Codes, and all the stuff that we see today, including licenses, whether it's a marriage, business, whatever like that, right? All these are slave codes, right? The supreme law of the land is the Constitution. So we stand on the fact that there is a Constitution, an act, which Canada's Constitution is, cannot be a Constitution. And you can also go to Walter Kuhl, K-U-H-L, Walter, K-U-H-L, and the Canada, the land without a Constitution, to get a reference point from people in Parliament who know that Canada doesn't have a Constitution. Not outside people, people who are part of quote-unquote Canada government talking out about where's the Constitution at, how come there isn't one, all right? Representing yourself as a human being means, again, that you're not Negro, Black, Colored, or Ethiopian. You're Moorish American. You're Aboriginal and Indigenous to the land, and you cannot represent yourself. You can only present yourself. Because to represent yourself means that somebody has hold on you, somebody has bond on you, somebody has a contract on you, somebody has something making you not able to speak or making you be a ward. And once you're a ward, then somebody has to talk on your behalf, hence be represented. But as Moors, we present ourselves, and we present ourselves in propria persona, or in proper person, or as ourself, in our capacity as Moorish American, American, Moors, nationals of the land, Aboriginal, Indigenous people, right? So, if you're in Canaanland, 2533A Eglinton Avenue West, Moor Science Temple of America, is where we're at. Look for the big Moroccan flag in the window. Every Sunday, 1 p.m., we're at the temple. Fridays, 7:30 p.m. You can contact the temple, 647-745-6664. All right. But, you know, again, crazy. Crazy emails. I don't know what this is. But, your brother Yashua L, Circle 7 Yashua, email account. If you get this, because you already know we build or whatever, if you get this, just send me an email. Yashua L. Because this email is in a different language and all that stuff, and it looks a little suspect. Brother Hassan sends his Islam to the Moors. The attached prepared documentation pertains to further research pertaining to cancer cure. Brief from the research pertaining to Dr. Joanna Budwig, shared by Brother James Watson Bey and Brother Taj Tariq Bey. So do your research, Dr. Joanna, J-O-H-A-N-N-A, Budwig, B-U-D-W-I-G. From Brother Hassan again. Do your diligence and research to double, triple check the references for whom to send courtesy copies. Those listed below supersede the quasi-national jurisdictions pertaining to city, county, town, township, borough, and other municipalities, though some are colorable. Strategy is key in enforcing the Constitution. If corrections need to be made, then do so and share the corrections made. I'm not above correction or being corrected. And so, once again, the idea of making sure that you check your CC list, make sure you check your CC list, double check, triple check your CC list, so that you're sending your writs to the right place. Right, you want to make sure that you're sending your writs to the right places. All right. Sister Divine Bay, I wanted to know if you can provide a link to where I could get a copy of the letter that our sister was reading from on the broadcast of May 31st, 2017 on the YouTube channel. If you go to rvbaypublications.com, majority of the things on Brother Najib's channel are from the MHHS classes on Blog Talk Radio. If there are things that were spoken about in the class as far as documents or stuff like that, more than likely they're on the website. They're uploaded to the website, rvbaypublications.com. And classes, again, for Blog Talk Radio, blogtalkradio.com/MHHS-eyes-wide-open. Every Tuesday, 9:30 p.m., you can call in 347-945-5899, or you can go on Blog Talk Radio and listen that way. Feel free to call in, questions, comments, testimonials, whatever it is, you know what I mean, open lane, free to call in. Brother Rashad L, just making sure my writ was sent and received through Dropbox. If so, could you just reply back? This is a writ of special appearance I'm sending out now before next week, before I make a special appearance at the de facto tribunal concerning an artificial person that they're still trying to impose me as being. Despite me sending out multiple writs and putting my status on the record, I would just ignore it since I know I'm not the straw man nor go. But I don't really want to take the chance of these criminals in uniform. So I'll just make my special appearance, declare my status again for and on the record, thanks. Now, remember that, again, these people, time's up for them. So, you know, they are trying everything that they can to get the people, they're trying everything that they can to get the people to give up the right. And the biggest thing that they're using is threat, duress, and coercion. Right? Not that, you know, they haven't been using that, but they're, you know, that's where That's how they know they're going to get people to not be on birthrights. You know, by threats, duress, and coercion. So, again, why the importance of studying? Because with studying, you you solidify your ground. You extend your roots into the soil deeper. So that when the challenge does present itself, you're an immovable object by that time. That regardless of what they say, regardless of what they do, you're gonna stand on birthrights. Again, we're gonna use the, you know, for us, you know what I mean, the pinnacle of standing on birthrights, again, Brother Mario Elbe, you know, getting sent to the hole and not stepping off of the birthright. Right? Having to survive in the hole and still not giving up the birthright. Still sticking to the point that I'm not that name that you guys are trying to, and then eventually, you know what I mean? They, you know, they don't want to waste any more fiat that they don't have, paying staff and all this type of stuff, dealing with this individual who clearly isn't going to budge from his position. No, but we just get him the hell out of here and, you know, call it a loss, right? Still on birthrights. Like that's just what he did. You know what I mean? You know, it's unfortunate that some people are gonna have to suffer. Some people are gonna have to go through the ringer. You know what I mean? I wouldn't look at it as something to take personal. You know what I mean? Know that this is a divine movement first, and you know, Allah is working in mysterious ways with regard to this birthright and Moors. And if Moors aren't careful, they're gonna get caught up in stuff that they shouldn't be caught up in. And the only reason that they get caught up is because they start forgetting that this has to do with self. You know what I mean? This doesn't have to do with how much books you got, how much videos you put out, how much, you know what I mean? This has to do with self. Do you know who you are? When is it know thyself? Do you really know? If you don't really know, then you're going to have problems exercising birthrights, because this is based on being what you know. So if you don't know yourself, you shouldn't be exercising. Right? That's just what it is. You know what I'm saying? Brother Khalid Amin Bey, I would like to start off by thanking you brothers in Canaanland for helping to uplift fallen humanity. I am not the most studious or scholarly, but thanks to you all, RV Bay Publications, Mario L. Bay, and others, I've been able to go to sources and verify on what's being discussed, helping me to lift the veil of ignorance and to further my pursuit of being an active participant in the Moorish divine and national movement of the world. So sincere thanks. I would like to become an honorary member of the temple. Secondly, I just recently moved to Georgia and was hoping you could point me in the direction of Moors in Atlanta area that I could build with, have witnesses, etc. Finally, I was digging y'all's I'm Not Black t-shirts. I recently had a shirt printed and would like your opinion. I am doing anything sacrilegious by having the fez printed on the back. Signing off in our principles of love, truth, peace, freedom, and justice, your brother Khalid Amin Bey. Well, Islam Moor, the shirts look good. You know what I mean? And I don't know about sacrilegious and all that stuff. This is birthrights. So, you know what I mean? You do what you will once you adhere into those principles. And that's the truth, you know. As far as the honorary membership, anybody wanting to be an honorary member of
Canaanland Moores, Moore Science Temple of America. You can email Brother Amari L. Bay at amarilbay@hotmail.com. amarilbay@hotmail.com. So make sure you email him if you want to be an honorary member of the Moore Science Temple in Canaanland. And, you know, keep studying. You know, if you're a member of Canaanland Moore's Temple, then you already know that our online university is rvbaypublications.com. Go there and get your studying on. You know, you got the email. If you got questions, feel free to send questions, you know what I mean? We'll do what we can to get you the answers that you're looking for, or at least direct you in the right area to get those answers. A few more questions before we close out. And as well, if there's any Moors that are in the Atlanta area, Brother Khalid Bay is looking for some Moors out in that area. All right. There's a lot of emails relative to using the temple as a CC, right, for their writs and stuff like that. So we also employ the Moors to do that, to tie yourself back to Nova Drawley and the nation and stuff like that. If you are an honorary member and you're writing writs and stuff like that, feel free to address one to the temple in your CC list, because it also shows, you know, that you have allegiance with a branch of something founded by Nova Drawley, right? On top of sending to whoever else you're sending to, add your regencies and your consulates to the CC list. Brother Hassan questions, did Prophet Nova Drawley use astrology / cosmology? Two, if so, why is astrology, cosmology so important in uplifting fallen humanity? And three, how does astrology and cosmology tie into civics? Gratitude indeed, beloved, for your consideration and correspondence. I know all natural beings need to hear this for the record. So, did Nova Drawley use astrology / cosmology? Nova Drawley said that the Moorish flag is a red flag with a 5-point star. That's green. The green 5-point star is relative to astrology and cosmology, because that's the only place where stars are at. So, not to get long-winded, but when you hear people talk crazy about Nova Drawley didn't bring that and all that stuff, remember about the flag, especially when they start talking against astrology, right? If you can find me a star somewhere other than in the cosmological, astrological realm of existence, right? Then we can say Nova Drawley didn't mean that. Because I'm pretty sure stars are relative to the universe. Right? The importance of cosmology for uplifting fallen humanity is because all of humanity that is fallen is because they didn't, quote-unquote, consider
They didn't consider astrology and cosmology for their salvation. Because again, the people have been trained to think that astrology and cosmology is occult, devil worship and stuff, but every year they celebrate their birthday. But that's not occult. And they celebrate their mom's birthday. And they celebrate, which everything is based on a calendar, which is based on some type of astrological location to get this day on this calendar that somebody's saying, let's celebrate something. So everything's based on astrology and cosmology. And again, humanity has fallen because they strayed away from those lessons and got caught up in church being the quote-unquote religion, when astrology is really the religion. That's why these books are, books dealing with the sun and how it impacts, or the sun and the moon and how they impact everything around them, planets, individuals, different constellations, the power of the magnetism, the power of knowing that you're one with something else that's greater than you. Right? If the people would realize that, the uplifting of fallen humanity would happen by the people themselves. Just by them studying astrology and cosmology, they would uplift themselves. Because you can't, the beauty about astrology is that after you know, you can't lie to yourself after. Because that's not opinion. Right? Your sign being in a particular constellation, on a particular moon, on whatever, is specific to you. So you can't hide from that. You can't make that not exist because, you know, well, I wanted to go to the store today and a black box there and they said I can't go. Well, I'm going to go anyways. Then you crash your car or something like that. And, you know, you're complaining, arguing with this guy because, you know, he rear-ended you, so it's his fault, and but your dumbass was the one that went out there. When it was black box day, you're supposed to stay your ass home. Why are you going outside to do stuff when you're not, you didn't follow? And then the more you don't follow, the more stuff's going to go on. Until here we are in blackness now. We strayed so much from the astrological, cosmological lessons that now we're in total darkness. No stars, no planets, no nothing. Just darkness. Right? How does astrology and cosmology tie into civics? The astrological, cosmological world is governed by universal law. The earth plane, or man's existence, is governed by nature's law, right? The Holy Trinity, universal law, nature's law, and common law, all work hand in hand. Right? They all work hand in hand. When all the three of them are working hand in hand, you have no need for justice. Love, truth, peace, freedom. There's no issues. As soon as you have foreign law introduced, it throws off the flow. So now you have imbalance. Right, you have, so the imbalance has been going on so long today that now, you know, people are getting killed on the street on camera, police still getting off. Right? Because this is a perpetuated thing. Now remember that cosmologically, the realm of the ancestors is familiar with our ignorance. The idea of Noble Drawley bringing us back in the constitutional fold of government, or teaching us to be civic-minded, or teaching us to be constitutional, was for us, from a spiritual perspective, to be acknowledged by the ancients again. Because with the teachings of Noble Drawley, we would vibrate on the frequency that would make us emit the light, which would let the ancestors know that, you know, we're not in darkness anymore, so now they can come assist. Just ask anybody who's really on more science. Of, like, for real, how ancestors step into their life to get them out of a situation. Like, ancestors stepped in. Like, they were, there was no chance in heaven for them. Then all of a sudden, here comes a chance. Because of ancestor. And they equate that to, because I'm Moorish American and I know that I'm more, that I was able to pick up on the frequency that allowed me to get out of this situation. Right? We're not talking book sense, we're talking the ancestral forces stepping in. So the ancestral forces are only gonna step into people, or to step in to assist people who are vibrating on the frequency that they emit the light. And in order for you to emit the light, you would have to have the universal laws, the natural laws, and the common law working in harmony. When you get this information, all this stuff Noble Drawley brought, you have one of those three aspects not solidified, and you'll realize eventually that that's how you have hiccups in your exercising of your birthrights. That the Holy Trinity was out of place, there was an imbalance in it. Either you're studying too much universal laws, not enough natural laws. Or you're overcompensating on studying the Constitution and not even dealing with the universal laws, not dealing with astrology, not dealing with anything having to do with celestial anything. Right? There has to be balance maintained. That's the whole point of, you know, the compass and the square. Balance being maintained. Right? So, 9 o'clock, Islam to all the Moors that tuned in today, first day back after a fairly long layoff, you know, but it is all good. It is all good. We are gonna be going live again this Sunday, 1 p.m. at 2533 A Eglinton Avenue West. So we'll see you then. Until then, you know, we'll close out with our prayer, of course. And keep in mind, you know what I mean, life is short. You know what I mean? So let those know who you love, that you love them. Because life is super short. Super short. And we don't want you to, you know, take this thing for granted, because we're in this place of, you know, we know ourselves. It's good that we know ourselves. It's amazing that we know ourselves. But make sure you take some time to deal with the higher perspective. You know what I mean? Make sure you deal with the higher perspective. Right? So we'll just do our closeout prayer. Five on the left, two on the right. Allah, the Father of the universe, Father of love, truth, peace, freedom, and justice. Allah is my protector, my guide, and my salvation by night and by day through his holy prophet, Noble Drawley. Islam.
Yeah, sending this one out to my man Killer B. No doubt, indeed. Without weed, you know what I'm saying? That old real shit. There's a war going on outside, no man is safe from. You could run, but you can't hide forever from these streets that we done took. You walking with your head down, scared to look. You shook, cause ain't no such things as halfway crooks. They never around when the beef cooks. In my part of town, it's similar to Vietnam. Now we all grown up and old and beyond the cops' control. They better have the riot gear ready. Tryna back me and get rock steady. By the Mac one double, I touch you and leave you with not much to go home with. My skin is thick, cause I'll be up in the mix of action. If I'm not at home, puffin' live, relaxing. New York got a nigga depressed, so I wear a slug proof underneath my guest. God bless my soul before I put my foot down and begin to stroll into the drama I built. And oh, I'm finished beef, you will soon be killed. Put us together, it's like mixing vodka and milk. I'm going out blasting, taking my enemies with me. And if not, they draw, so they will never forget me. Lord, forgive me, the Hennessy got me not knowing how to act. I'm falling and I can't turn back. Or maybe it's the words from my man Killer Black that I can't say, so what's left an untold fact. Until my death, my goal's to stay alive. Survival of the fit, only the strong survive.
Yo, we live in this till the day that we die. Survival of the fit, only the strong survive. We live in this till the day that we die. Survival of the fit, only the strong survive. We live in this till the day that we die. Survival of the fit, only the strong survive. We live in this till the day that we die. Survival of the fit, only the strong survive.
I'm trapped in between two worlds trying to get dope. You know when the dope get low, the juice go. But never that, as long as things smoke crack, I'll be on the block hustling, yeah, on my stack. No doubt, watching my back and proceed with caution. 5-0 working, no time to get lost in. The system niggas using fake names to get out quick. My brother did it and got back with 2 ounces. I live with one with scores, hit the block hard. That's my man Twin when he got back. That fucked me up, God. But shit happens for a reason. You find out who's the true keepers when you're upstate bleeding. You can't find a shorty to troop your bed with you. Hit with a 2-4 is difficult. While on the streets, I try to maintain. Tight with my Lucas, hoes like to run game. Some niggas like to trip, but I ain't with that tricking shit. I'm like a juke, saving dope so I can bit with pushing the legs. Now I'm set, ready to jet. No matter how much loot I get, I'm staying in the projects forever. Takes on the blocks, we out clever. And beef, we never separate, grow together. When worse come to worse, my peoples come first. Try to react and get the motherfucker feeling served. My crew's all about blue. Fuck looking cute, I'm strictly tin boots. An army certified suits, puffin' nails. Lay back, enjoy the smell. In the bridge, getting down, it ain't hard to tell. You better realize
this till the day that we die. Survival of the
fit,
only the strong survive.
Living this till the day that we die. Survival of the Moors, only the Moors survive. Islam, Moors, peace and love.
Yo, it's the P, E double, push your legs bubble in the winter.
I bumped into my boy from Left Rack, Shameek's homeboy, E Money Bags, on my way to Chung King Studio by the Holland Tunnel in Manhattan. Bags and I always randomly cross paths. He loved Mobb Deep. You the God, Pete, for killing these niggas with Quiet Storm, he said. Bags was a well-known ghetto celeb. The female rapper Foxy Brown even shouted him out on the Firm song, Affirmative Action. Bags and I started hanging out every day after that, talking for hours about the Illuminati, secret societies, the corrupt government, and history of the Moors, and history of the Moors, and history of the Moors.